Okay, second take now.
Scratch Bandicoot!
Yeah, I tried recording this early, it didn't turn out so great. So, here's the deal. I have played Crash Bandicoot games before, but never the original trilogy. It was only, like, Rat for Cortex, Twinsanity, those two GBA Crash games. So now that I have the N-sane Trilogy, I can finally play the first three for myself. Let's go. Yeah, sure. There was a previous recording I tried to do, but kinda got ruined. No interruptions and all that.
But Dr. Cortex, we haven't determined the cause of past failures.
Moron! This Bandicoot will be my general. He will lead my Cortex commandos to world domination. This time, I shall reign triumphant. We are closer than ever before. Quickly, into the vortex.
Dr. Cortex, the vortex is not ready. We have no idea what it could do.
Failure again. Capture him. Prepare the female Bandicoot.
Swear, those assistant guys look freaking weird. I think I read somewhere that they're actually all robots. It's kind of funny. Hopefully I can keep track of the drop shadow. Have any slip-ups. Off the ledge, I'm gonna have to be more careful. Heard about the hitboxes in this version. Seems I'm out of pill shape. Let's test that theory. Huh. I could stand on this ledge. Man, I missed a slide. Does it get that in the second or third game? Okay, there we go. I missed that last one, that'd just be embarrassing. you eat that. Yeah, he's not the sharpest tool in the shed, but the dude can drive a motorcycle, you know? You think he had some sense. Maybe some pockets in those pants? I don't know. Noticed that before. You see how I can reach up there though. Actually did it. It happened a lot, huh? Never gonna get all the boxes in the first try, am I? I have to collect like a certain amount of gems or something. There's no crystals to get, I think that's in the sequels. I'm going to be collecting a lot of Wumpa fruit. Insurance, really. You never know what might happen. Thank you. actually. Of course. Is this, are the gems of a specific color, or do I just have to collect enough of the standard ones? Okay, now this I'm especially familiar with, because it kept showing up in, I think it showed up like twice in Uncharted 4. Plus it's pretty iconic in general, really. Let's hope all that practice in that game paid off then. You know, the real difference should be prettier graphics, right? We sure this dude don't got pockets. So of course, probably odd that I had a PS1 growing up and yet I never played Crash. That's because I ended up playing Spyro instead. So I'm kind of used to more like open level design type stuff. That's what I grew up with. No linear, straight-up challenge thing like this. Yeah, 2D platformers for that. Nothing wrong with stuff like this, though. I mean, it's fine. Just not as used to it in 3D, I guess. Like, the straight-up platforming challenges with no explorations, any expansive kind. I guess that's why something like this appealed to a lot of older gamers that grew up with only 2D back in the 80s, perhaps. And that's how this game got notoriety, because it kind of kept the whole linear challenge type of deal, just in the 3D space. Something tells me I'm gonna need these extra lives later down the road. I've heard stories about certain levels on the first island. That was a boss fight? Dang. Probably the easy part of the game so far. Just one more level and then that's it for part one. No. All right then. How many times has it been now? Is she like constantly breaking out and she just keeps catching her again? That must get tedious. Slightly off. Alright, both bonus stages. Did he just blow himself up or did he teleport? That view was weird. Wait, did I get them all? Nope. Yeah, figures. You know, it's funny, I think the boulder chase level is probably the easiest level to get a gem on so far. Isn't that weird? Anyway, I guess I'm gonna to cut things off for now, continue from this stage. Something tells me this isn't gonna be fun.